Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another episode of Creative Lightroom. This week we're going to have a look at how we can create the look and feel of an HDR effect, but from a single image. Now HDR, you either love it or you hate it. You've already decided which camp you fall in. Most people are quite happy with HDR, provided it's not the kind of the crazy, cartoony, over-the-top stuff. And that includes me. So to get an HDR look, I need a picture that has plenty of detail in the shadows, plenty of detail in the highlights, possibly some nice punchy colours as well, and a little bit of an edge, a sort of a crispness. So that's what we're going to create using nothing more than the standard features of Lightroom 5, although this is also compatible with Lightroom 4. So let's have a look at our starting picture, because that's kind of important. So the picture I'm going to start with is this one right here. And the reason this is going to make a great pseudo or fake HDR effect is because if I go to the histogram and I turn on the clipping for the shadows and the highlights, you'll notice there's no highlight clipping in here at all. There'd be a sort of a red little spotches and blotches if there were. Even this area, which I thought probably was blown out, has some detail in it. The shadows, there's a little bit of blocking on the shadows, but that's okay. A little bit on the shadows is all right. You don't want too much blown out highlights, otherwise this effect doesn't work. So we've established this is going to be a good image for HDR. So let's jump into the basic panel here and make a few changes. Now the changes really are all about bringing out shadow and highlight detail. That's at heart what HDR actually is. So let's go to the highlights and I'm going to bring that all the way down, 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 down to -100. So I've recovered the maximum amount of highlight detail that I can. And this area of sky that was formerly completely blown out, or at least it looked like it, you can see actually there's loads of detail in here. Now it's worth stressing, I'm using a RAW file. If you're trying to do this with a JPEG image, you're not going to get anywhere near as much data recovered. So that works for the highlights. What about the shadows? Well, let's increase the shadows. So we'll go up, 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 all the way up to maximum +100. And I'll recover as much of the shadow detail as I can. And this is really starting to have that HDR feel. Now, it's worth noting that although I'm going up to maximum for the shadows and highlights, you don't have to with your images. You may find that maybe 80 or 90 is exactly the position you want to be in. Remember, this is a guide. It's not a rule. So that's the shadows and the highlights, but when you look at the histogram, you can see what I've done is I've really kind of clipped the highlights in the wrong direction. There's really nothing up here at all. If you notice, if I hover over the histogram and I move from side to side, notice how it's on highlights down on the basic panel below, and if I move across, it jumps down to whites, telling me that I've really lost the whites. Now I could just move around inside the histogram there and move the whites, but I like to use the sliders. So I'm going to come down here and just pull my whites up a little bit until the edge of the histogram just gets to the edge there. And that gives me a great amount of detail in the whites. Same with the blacks. I can come in here and just move my histogram in a little bit until I find I'm no longer clipping the blacks. So now I've got a nice full range of tones in that picture, but plenty of shadow and highlight detail. Now one more slider I like to use when I'm doing my pseudo HDR effect. And that's clarity. I don't know whether I ever mentioned it. Did I ever mention how I kind of like clarity? I love clarity, totally addicted. So I'm going to get the clarity slider. I'm going to push it high, really high. Yeah, maximum. So I'm going to really max out the slider. Ever since Lightroom 4, then you've been able to do this because you've had shadows and highlights and this new clarity. And I absolutely love it. Great effect. Now, this is all well and good, and I'm going to actually, just thinking about it, I'm just going to put a bit of vibrance and saturation in there too, because I want a more punchy color. Trouble is, when you start really throwing around these sliders, then particularly the shadow slider, you start to find you get some noise in your picture. So let's zoom into 1:1 actual pixels, wait for it to render, and oh, goodness me, lots of noise in the picture. Now, this isn't exactly a high ISO, it was only ISO 400, so it wasn't really a high ISO shot, but by moving those sliders to the extreme, you emphasize the noise in your picture. So to manage the noise, I'm going to jump down to the detail tab, and on the detail tab, I'm going to come down to the noise reduction. There it is. Now by default, noise reduction is always on zero for luminance, so I'm going to increase that until my noise just kind of melts away. Now, I don't want to go too far because I'll melt away the whole picture and it'll look silly. And I don't mind some noise in the picture. There was some noise there originally, so a bit of noise is okay. And I reckon about 50 in this case looks fine. I can also see a bit of color noise coming through here as well. So let's take the color noise slider and we'll increase that. And you can really push that quite high. Don't be afraid of that one, just to really reduce the amount of color noise in the shot. One last thing to do before we finished, and that is to go down even further to the effects and find the post-crop vignetting and apply a little bit of post-crop vignetting just to darken in those edges. So there you go, that is the picture completed. Let's have a little look at a before and after so we can see exactly how that looks. And as you can see, the difference between the two pictures is striking. It's dramatic. The HDR picture just has that much more quality in it as far as detail in the shadows and detail in the highlights. So there you are. That's how you can create your own pseudo HDR image. Now, if you want to find out more about me, don't forget to visit my website at www.gavtrain.com or visit me again right here next week for another Creative Lightroom. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.